Finally, after a few months of fooling around with this pattern, I did come up with a double slipper pattern. Now, I like to have live stitches in the beginning and live stitches at the end so I could graft. If you don't want to do that, you could cast on with a closed cast on, bind off in the end, and sew those together. It's really up to you. My pattern tells me to cast on 23 stitches and then work up waist yarn or row of ravel cord and then knit one row of the main color. Now I'm going to do the short rows here. So I'm taking my, I believe they're Russell Lovers, but the front ones here on the LK150. It's the same as the LK140 and the KX350 and probably some other machines. Bringing those back so whatever needles I have out into holding position will not knit. So I'm going to knit until I have 8 stitches on each side and then 7 stitches in the center. Taking the needle from that was last knitted out to holding position, and that's going to do an automatic wrap. Moving my outside claw weights as needed. Now when I'm done with the short rows, I'm going to reverse short row back. So I take the yarn, put it underneath the last needle, the first needle on the carriage side, the inside here. So the first stitch is going to be manually wrapped. I'm going to put one claw weight in the center there. Now I'm going to bring two needles opposite the carriage on the inside, the needles in holding position. Put them to forward working position, knit across, bring the last needle that was knitted back to holding position, this way it's going to automatic wrap. And do that until all stitches are back in working position. I don't have that problem when I have both hands on the carriage, so I couldn't really get the camera another way for you to see what I'm doing. And as you see, it's when I'm pulling it towards me. And I do have to make sure these end stitches are knit in. Sometimes the second one in doesn't knit for some reason, but I keep an eye on it. Now I'm going to reset my counter back to zeros. I could have taken it off because I didn't really need it counting the short rows. And according to my pattern, I'm going to knit 34 rows now. Now I'm going to do the short rows again, the same thing as before. And of course, short row back. Next, I take my 3 claw weights and I hang them on the back side because I want to do a sew as you go. But I want to point out that you got the line coming in here from the short rows. I'm going to take the stitch before it, right here, and hang it on that end needle. So on this side here, you can see as I pull it out, there's that line going down made from the short rows. So I'm going on this side of the short rows and taking that one loop from the outside stitch. I have my carriage set to normal knitting. I'm going to knit two rows. And now I just go every second row. So that was the loop. There's the knot. So I'm going to take the next loop. And then the same on the opposite side. And I'm going to continue doing this for the 34 rows that I had before. And I'm going to be stopping on this side of the short rows right here. Now as I'm getting towards the end here of these short rows, I count the loops and I have 1, 2, 3. And then here I have 1, 2, and I've done this more often than I should have. But what I do is, instead of ripping this all back and redoing it all over, is I will hang that side normal. But then I come here, and sometimes I need to use my latch tool to grab what would be the knot. Just to compensate for that one row I'm off someplace. Sometimes it's harder to get these knots, especially when you got it down. Now I'm on tension dial 4. Okay, there we go. I go back to the normal loop. The normal loop. So I have 3 rows right together on this side here, but it's really not going to make that much of a difference. And here I'm on the last loop before that, the short rows there, and the same on this side. And I just knit one row across. Now I'm going to short row down to 12 stitches, 6 stitches on each side, and then 11 in the center. So just like before, although I probably should hang my claw weights up here now. And this way here, it'll also, these claw weights will help keep the other short rows here out of the way. Again, moving your claw weights up as needed. I forgot to mention that on the bond machines, I found I had to put these up like every second row. If not, then the stitches would pop off the needle. So just watch your loops, stitches on the needles. If they're starting to come up, put those claw weights up. Before I short row back, I put my tension dial down 1 click. These machines only have the full number and a half one. The metal bed machines, you have 2 clicks, 2 dots in between each number. You could do 1 click. I don't know if that's going to do enough, maybe 2 clicks. I did 1 slipper with all of it at tension dial 4, and it worked out fine for me, no problem. The bond machines, you want to go either 1 or a half a key plate lower than what you're using. Also, you may want to change colors here so that you know where the lining is. Not necessarily. You could always mark it and you could see by the stitch size as well, or at least I could. So now I'm going to reverse short row back. Okay, so now my pattern tells me to knit 34 rows. I need to put my counter back to zero. And I'm going to move my claw weights up. And knit the 34 rows. Again, I am going to short row down to 8 stitches on both sides, 7 in the middle. Moving my side claw weights up as needed. The one in the middle there could stay there. It's going to hold the middle of the work down, no problem. And again, reverse short row it on this. So first of all, take that yarn, put it underneath the first needle on the inside on the carriage side. Bring the next two needles over here to forward working position. Last needle that was knitted back to hold, two needles to forward working position. And just keep doing that until you have all the needles or all the stitches back in work again. Again, I am going to do the sew as you go. And this way here, you don't have any sewing to do in the end. You do have, if you started out with live stitches, you do have the grafting to do. You could do it on the machine or by hand. And maybe a couple little stitches on the side, which I'll show you in the end. So again, I look, I find that line there. I just take the stitch before it. I need to get my carriage so it'll knit the stitches from hold. And I don't care if the carriage is on the left or the right. You've probably seen some patterns, tells you the carriage has to be on the right. I really don't bother with that. As long as my pattern works up, I'm happy. Knit two rows. Again, go down two rows on the side here, pick up that loop, and hang it on the end needle. Knit two rows. So I'm going to continue that until just before the short rows here. One more time, I'm going to short row down to 8 stitches on each side. Now because it's kind of bulky here, I took one claw weight, hung it on the back. But I need these others up front, not only to hold that down, but easier for me to grab to put them in as I'm working. And last, I am going to short row down to 6 stitches on each side. Again, moving your claw weights up as needed. Three, four, five, six. Six. I always like to hang the claw weights right underneath when I finish the short rows. And I want to do the reverse short rows. But now I need to put my tension dial back to 4. If you moved it down, just put it back to the beginning number is all. And reverse short row back. A little bit easier with both hands. Now I'm all done with the knitting part of it. Now, I like to take my work off on a hand knitting needle and graft it that way. You could go ahead and graft it on the machine. You just need to take your first row here. Well, bring your needles out to hold, which I need that anyways. And then you're going to take the first row that was knitted and hang them on the hooks and then graft them with the purl sides facing each other. I hope to remember to put a clickable link to my other two videos that I have on grafting. The one on the machine, I will try to get it to the point of where it does go from purl to purl or purl side facing each other. Now, as I'm taking this off with my hand knitting needle, I start opposite of where the yarn tail is. And then I just go into each stitch and push that needle back. I could have worked it off on waste yarn and then got this last row on my hand knitting needle. So now I need to graft this first row and last row together. I want to mention that if you were to hand graft the first and last row together, I wouldn't have the waste yarn because it's going to be on the inside, and when you're done, this makes a tube. Now here you see the little holes on the side. That's a little bit of sewing. It's not going to take much to do. Then as I feel the two fabrics, this one here is the tighter, so that is the linen. So I'm going to take the linen from the toe and start pushing it in. Till I get it to the other toe. And then I'm going to take the inside of the heel, push it into the inside of the heel. And there, I have it all. Well, it's not all done. I got to sew these little things. But it's all done. So now I'm just going to take this end here, do a couple little whip stitches on that side, tie them together, pull the yarns inside, go on the opposite side, tie that in together. And, of course, you're going to make the mate, but I already have my first one done. And I like the feel of this. Well, I hope you get to make some of these double slippers, especially the person that asked me about them.